There we go. Hello! Playing some Mighty Number 9. It is finally on my PlayStation 4. I was a backer, and I have waited patiently for this game. Let's play normal mode. I've never played it. This is the first time. I'm starting it for the first time, so anybody joining me, you're watching it for the first time. Excuse me, my Batman shirt is uncovered. Oh, jeez, I don't want to reveal too much. Okay, let's see how this game is. Let's hear a little bit of this.
Breakthroughs in robotic technology have ushered in a new era of peace and prosperity.
Okay.
Violence is confined to the Battle Coliseum, where robot combatants face off in spectacular duels. Today, the Colosseum walls once again echo with the shouts and cheers of excited fans. When, suddenly...
Well, they could tell the story to set this up a little bit better, I'll tell you that right now. Ah! This looks familiar. Let's see what happens here.
System ready. Go.
Professor. Beck. And functioning normally, it would appear. What on earth has happened? It's chaos everywhere. Well, we won't figure it out here. We must make for the laboratory. And quickly!
Beck, okay.
Forge ahead and clear a secure path. I'll follow and monitor your progress.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Alright. I don't know whether to use the analog stick or the D-pad on something like this. Alright, here we go. Right. Just one pitiful little jump here. Okay, here we go.
Once again, the president has declared a countrywide state of emergency. This based on reports of haywire robots rampaging out of control in all 52 states. I'm being told we have a comment from Gregory Graham, CEO of Cherry Dynamics. Cherry Dyne, of course, being the world's leading robot manufacturer. Let's go there now, live.
Attention! Attention! Is this thing on? My fellow Americans, in this time of crisis, we at Cherry Dyne would just like to express that this isn't our fault. It's that Dr. Blackwell.
I'm gonna put the chat stuff. On the phone, so I can go full screen on the vid here.
We are doing all we can to help fix the situation.
All right. Advanced settings. Okay. There we go. All right, back to game. So I can read your chat, your chat comments on the chat below here. Thanks for joining me today, by the way. A little Mighty Number 9 action. Let's see if this game is any fun. Been hearing a lot of the tepid, mediocre reviews, or hearing about the tepid, mediocre reviews, and that breaks my heart. I've been waiting a long time for this thing. The spiritual. Homage for Mega Man,
Beck, no other way.
Developed by Keiji Inafune. I was a backer on Kickstarter,
I know you can.
So I've been waiting forever.
Professor, I'll do it.
No, I turned the music off, but I guess it's still there. Let's see. Tips. I guess the music's always gonna be there. Okay. Game options. Tips, controls, question mark, other. Oh, I have a retro one too. Or I have golden back because I'm a backer. Okay, let's see. There we go. Okay, golden back. Yeah. And it's so funny, that a good comment there, Simiao. Oh, I see. That Capcom Mega Man Collector's Edition was supposed to be in response to this game being released, and those old NES games are still incredible, man! Inafune-san knows that, and that's why this game was built, because this is the kind of stuff that he wanted to do. It sucks if this is, well, we'll know soon. We will know together. This is my first time, first level. Okay, I can zip like that. Okay, got it. Okay. So I'm collecting Zell or something like that. Okay.
Wait. That's one like it. Huge.
All right.
That's one like.
Looks pretty cool so far.
Zonda, what's the matter?
Good!
What's the matter? What the bleeding heck do you think's the matter? Are you okay, Will?
Oh, fine. Fine. More or less. And yourself?
Less than fine. Much less. These robots gone wild are tearing the place apart. I've sealed myself in the lab. Who knows how long before they break through?
Control so far, all right. Yeah, Simiao, another good comment. Yeah, what would have been done if it was a big company? I mean, I think the challenge these days is these 2D scrollers, they're not huge games. They're not enormous, so they can't really invest tons of money into these things. It'll be interesting to see, though, if Capcom says, okay, well, here's our Mega Man game, and does something similar. Sometimes it's kind of cool for people that are just fans to carry on in the spirit of the original, like Doom, the recent Doom game. Which was made by some id vets for sure, but also a lot of people that are just fans of Doom and wanted to make something that really honored it. And it's a wonderful game. It is kind of crazy, though, that we're not seeing a lot more of these classic, like Metroid or Castlevania. Like, they're being borrowed from in some pretty spectacular ways, but there are these original properties that are just sort of sitting there dormant, and the easy solution would be for these companies to make polygon based 3D modeled 2D games based on these properties, and I for one want that for Metroid especially. I think in Nintendo's case, they don't want to take the easy road out. Oops. Hello! Doom is frickin' awesome. I'm loving it. Yeah, so amazing. Those explosions are not great. Yeah. I know. So I got to shoot the guys and then zap through them and collect their XEL. Excel or whatever they call it system. And I'm pressing the right bumper to do that move that zaps me through them. Oh shit. This is hard. Okay, got it. Okay, there we go. Gotcha, okay. Are the spikes gonna be one hit, one kill? Probably, right? Okay. Shit, knew it. Yeah, the Axiom Verge was an amazing accomplishment for sure. I had just played Ori and the Blind Forest, though, which was not a game made by one person. It's a pretty massive Metroid-like game. And it was pretty hard to compare those two. I really dug Axiom Verge, though. It was cool. I was just, as I was downloading this game, I was playing a little more Ratchet and Clank. And, boy, this is a rude awakening when you play the flashy, Mega Man-like Ratchet and Clank, and then you go to this. Which is not horrible, it's got the aesthetic that was promised. It just does seem, pretty straightforward, shall we say. King Jupe, 1989. No, we're not doing full 30-minute shows, but we're doing as much as we can on our channels, on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/EPNTV, and Facebook, and on Twitch, and on our website. So we are cranking. We just did, 35 videos at E3, lots of interviews and first impressions. And Rundown Every Day, which is our news section. And we're streaming a lot more. And today we're going to be unboxing an HTC Vive and getting into some VR content over the next little while. And we've got a lot of big reviews coming. BFG, the new Spielberg movie. Lots of fun stuff. We're always busy. I'll have a review of this once I soak some more hours into it. Man, I don't really have much firepower. Oh, shoit. Okay, I gotta concentrate. Oh, is the rundown up? That's awesome. I can't get back. Okay.
What was that?
A demolition unit. How on earth did it manage to get down there? Back, quickly. You must stop it before it destroys the entire laboratory.
Ah. Ow. Whack. He can't jump very high. Oh, I see. Okay, so when he's all purple like that, I'm supposed to zap through him. Okay, got it. Shit. Almost got him. Got him. Okay. Oh. Wow. That looks like early PS2 stuff. Youch. Shell, how would you guys pronounce X-E-L? Zell? Kel? Cal? Cal! All right, let's see. Let's see what's next. What's the retail price on this game? I paid $60 for the backer, and then I got the gold thing and some extra DLC.
They might be suffering from this robot affliction that's going around.
Crikey! It's like every bot in America went completely nuts all at once. Let me contact my brother at the head office in Tokyo. Maybe he can send help.
I guess lip syncing was a little out of the budget.
Please understand. The Japanese government won't let us intervene until we know the cause of the malfunctions.
I was afraid of that.
30-something.
But it makes sense.
All right.
After all, any robots you send to help could be affected as well, making things even worse.
Just to confirm, Mr. Sanda, if we can isolate the cause of the robot rampage, you'll send aid?
Absolutely, Professor White. Anything we can do. Did you have a plan in mind?
Yes. We'll send Beck to track down all his fellow Mighty Numbers. Great idea. Wait, what? His assimilation ability should filter any irregularities from his siblings' programming. If we can gather and study multiple samples, perhaps we can isolate the cause of the problem.
$22 on Steam, okay.
It's a long shot, but it's our only hope. The fate of the entire country hangs
in the balance. This is a $20 game.
I'll finish reactivating Call so she can provide support. Let's get to it.
If it doesn't sell, it'll go on sale pretty quick, too.
Professor,
I mean, I haven't played enough. You guys have seen everything that I've played. So far, not impressed, though.
New content in extra mode is here.
All right. Quit your lolling.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so we can choose. Quit your lollygagging.
Mighty number one. I guess we'll go for Mighty number one. Why not? Get Pyrogen.
You are all set then?
Okay, let's do it. We were busy. We were certainly hustling. One of the things that we did do, thank you for that. Your name is light green on white, so I can't read it. Ellipsia or something like that. I'm sorry, I can't read it. But our E3 content, thank you. Can I get up there? Yes, I can. Okay. One of the things that we did is we toned down the amount of interviews that we shot. And that was weird, because usually at E3, you know, we're getting lots of interviews that we then use in the show to talk about these games in kind of a preview state for weeks and months after the show. But we're recognizing that that's, you know, not necessarily the thing that our digital channels need. So our emphasis was on playing the games and then talking about them. And it was very efficient. You know, because when you're setting up the interviews, it's sometimes you're checking out the games, playing them for a bit, and then shooting the interviews afterwards. But there's always, you know, schedules and finding locations and all of that other stuff to contend with. So we were actually able to move from our meetings, which were mostly just gameplay sessions, and then I would get off the game that I was playing, and I'd turn around and start talking about it. And that was kind of a new challenge and something different for us on the show. We've kind of done a little bit of that stuff. Scott and I last year talked about the things that we were most excited about. But we were pretty diligent about just going to try things out and then talking about stuff. And we did pretty good. I think we saw a lot of stuff at E3. It was a good show. It was, certainly a weird one. You know, certainly a lot of discussion about how busy it was going to be or how much we needed it. But there were lots of good games, man. Lots of fun stuff to talk about. This is the year of the incredible shooter, I think. Ah. Okay. There are definitely tactics that I need to kind of familiarize myself with here. You know, you can't just go jumping into everything as these things are squashing me, keep reminding me. Okay, get him. Oh. And I keep forgetting that I have to go and get my Chell when I beat him up. Okay. Okay, whoa. There we go. Okay.
That's more like it.
All right. I want some abilities here. No, I didn't do anything with Kind of Funny this year. They were pretty freaking busy. I didn't really put myself out there to be interviewed by other people. I got asked by Jeff Cannata to be on the GameSpot show. They had their Tomorrow Daily thing, so I was interviewed by those guys. And I ran into Greg Grunberg, of all people, who's got a new show coming out with Kevin Smith on AMC. And I reconnected. He was on EP. He's been on EP a couple times. But just said hi and, you know, what are you doing? What's going on? And he said, oh, I'm shooting my show here. And then he offered to interview me for his show, which was surreal. But I just focused on getting the work done that we were going to have to do. And we did a lot, man. And thankfully, Ben and Steve and Jose all made time for EP and were a part of the content with us down there. And we got a lot of good stuff. I'm very happy with how E3 turned out. Lots of good meetings, too. Lots of really fun catch-ups and meet-ups with friends and stuff. Like the David Collins thing. I saw him at the EA press conference on the first day. And I love that guy. I've known that guy for years, but we're always just rushing from one appointment to the next when I see him at Comic-Con or E3 or something. And but we actually had time to go out and have lunch, and then I asked him to be on the podcast. And so if you haven't caught that interview with David, you definitely should. It was awesome. So that was a very fun extra thing that came out of E3 this year. Oh, okay. I saw Greg, though, man. Greg's a whirling dervish right now. He's got a lot going on with Kind of Funny. I'm so proud of those guys. And he was super gracious and kind. I ran into Tim as well. Those guys, their heads are spinning at how busy they have become and how much good stuff they have going on. Really, they're really wonderful people. I'm really happy for them. Okay, here we go. Whoosh.
Bring it on.
That is one crazy looking dude. He had what, like a horn out of his head with sunglasses on?
Here we go.
Potential cosplay right there. Okay. My kingdom for a double jump.
Here we go.
Okay. Okay, here we go.
That's more like it.
All right.
Here we go. Here we go.
I am so close to dying.
Here we go.
When do I get health? Oh man, look at that dude. Whoa. Ah. Thanks for the comments. Enjoy Witcher 3, Simeow. All right, let's see this. Thank you. Wow, he just stopped shooting at me. Okay.
Here we go.
Ah! Ouch, ouch, fire everywhere.
Bring it on.
What the frack, and how do I get out of there? Okay. That's pretty cool. Oh, thank you. That's pretty cool. Just pops out of nowhere and then explodes. Oh, boss fight. Why am I subjecting myself to this? I've been waiting for this. I'm a backer. I expected great things. Sajaja? Sajaja? Sajaja. I'm curious, and I suspect a few of you might be curious as well. This is a big deal. This thing raised all kinds of money as soon as Keiji Inafune put this thing up there, man. This is one of the biggest Kickstarter success stories in gaming history. And now it's out, and it should be better. We all kind of know that. Okay, that's cool. Whoa.
Bring it on. Bring it on.
All right. Whoa. Explosions could be way cooler than... Oh, shit. Way cooler than that. Any upgrades? I think I have to beat the boss first, and then I can upgrade. I have not demoed Batman VR yet. Soon.
Here we go.
VR content is going to be a part of our regular coverage. Very soon on our channels. We've got the Vive in so far, and the rest of them are coming. And we do in our first unboxing video of the Vive today, so, which is kind of what I wanted. I didn't really want to just be demoing these things in these little 10-minute bite-sized things. I want to play these games and play with these systems a little bit more to tell you guys if they're worth the price or not. If Mega Man didn't exist, what are my thoughts on this game? I would think it was a cute retro game, and it would feel like an old Super Nintendo game or something. But it does feel, you know, in the wake of shit. These games are hard to talk over. You need to concentrate. I'm playing like an easy level right now too. The thing is, with these games, we expect a lot out of them, though, you know? In this day and age.
Here we go.
Actually, don't know what all the buttons are. Let's see what the... Oh, that's cool. Okay, I didn't know I could do that. Okay, let's see. Game options. Controls. Okay. Attack, jump, accelerate, action, shift. Okay. I don't know if I can do that. It's form up, form down, direct change, form one. Okay, so I need to get some power up so I can change form. A la Mega Man. Oi, oi, oi. What? I don't think I want to do that. I'll fall. Okay. Wow. Ah, shit. Don't hit the walls! Brutal! Okay, let's start again. Hi! Hi, J-Lan. Restart. Alright, let's see where I start. No upgrades yet.
System ready? Go!
That's more like it.
A fire-wielding robot running wild at an oil refinery. I don't like the look of this at all.
Not exactly ideal conditions, I'll grant you that. Quickly now back. Locate Mighty Number One.
Ouch. I can't aim my, I don't know what those, icons over my character mean yet. Here we go. My game of E3 is, I think it's probably a tie between, we did a whole video on this, but the game I want to play the most is God of War, and Zelda's right there with it. So it's kind of a tie. I was really impressed with the reveal of God of War. The game I want to play this year the most, I think, is Deus Ex, but all the shooters look incredible. Titanfall, Titanfall 2, and Battlefield 1, and Call of Duty, they all look really good. I can't wait for all three of those. And I know there's tons of them that I'm forgetting about right now, but there are lots and lots of really fun things coming. I can't wait for the PlayStation VR system and the games that have been created specifically for it. Ouch. I'm looking forward to having an Xbox One S and testing out those that sucker and the new controller. Yeah, we have a lot of fun stuff headed our way. A lot of the like the biggest announcements. We've got to wait. We've got a long wait ahead of us. Detroit looks fantastic. Days Gone looks like fun. Actually, Dawn of War 3, I'm really psyched for. And Civ 6, I'm really psyched for. And I'm going to get right into the VR stuff, man. I'll be playing all of those games soon. I would not be surprised if Apple has a VR announcement for the iPhone this year. Okay, there's Pyro. Got to him before. Well, got this far before. Oh, yes, I am excited about The Last Guardian. You know what? Last Guardian was weird, though. They had, thanks for bringing up Guns of the Hellghast. Speaking of Hellghast, I am excited for, Horizon next year, but they had only a couple of demo screens for The Last Guardian, and there was always a line, so hardly anybody got to play. It was a 45-minute demo. It was not great thinking on Sony's part. I don't know what the thinking was there. Maybe it's like they know it's pre-sold already, and they didn't need to have us all play the thing, but I'm psyched. I hope it's good. I hope it's not problem filled or anything like that. I hope it lives up to the hype and the expectations. Okay, hold on a sec. Alright. It's such a weird idea to, like, shoot your enemies and then run through them. I don't think I've ever seen that mechanic before.
And such power. These designs of yours are something else, Will.
Yes, Will.
Last Guardian's been in development for like 9 years. Ah. Okay. Oh, this was the tricky part. Then he dies on the platform. Not some good skill right there. Ow! what would Batman do? You guys been reading all the Justice League reports? Zack Snyder and his team were flying out journalists that were not blown away by the movie, but had some good criticism and some positive things to say. I didn't get that invite. But they've had set visits, and so people are kind of saying that things have changed in a big way on the vibe of Justice League. Saying it's going to be a lot more Marvel-like. So it'll be interesting to see what happens next year. And apparently it's only one movie now. It's not going to be two. It's not going to be a two-part sequel. They're going to wait and see how the box office does on this one next year. Anybody out there excited for Justice League in 2017? Shit, come on, I did that before! Ah! Nintendo with the Virtual Boy. We have interviews with Sam Tramiel from Atari about the Jaguar VR from 1995. We were shooting all kinds of stuff. We have footage of the of that old system. I don't think it ever got released. I can't remember. I don't think so. Yeah, it's funny, man. Oh my god! Oh my god. I'm not good at this game. Okay. So apparently I have to concentrate because that that first platform is killing me too much. Okay, ah! Jesus. Alright, here we go. Get up there! Oh, Jesus Christ! Ah! I'm so embarrassed. Look, I'm all red. Okay. I think they just gave me a mercy extra person. Oh. Oh, boy. I need to go back to video game 101. Why was it so long until the industry revisited VR? I think some really painful lessons were learned the first time that you needed really fast processors to get super high frame rates and really high resolution textures on your as best you can on your graphics, on your video content, so people didn't get sick. Oh, fuck off! I'm hitting something up there and it's blocking me. That's nuts. Okay. Well, I'll play that again. That's just fun. This is fun stuff right there. Here we go. There it is. Ah, no more excuses. Bring it on. Okay. Oh boy. Intense. Oh my God. Oh. Now I remember Mega Man. I heard Nintendo will finally show. Did Tommy Tallarico do the music for this game? No, I don't think he did. I think a big deal was made about the music, like it's some retro artist. Nintendo doesn't normally do the Tokyo Game Show. I'll be very surprised if they're going to use the TGS for the NX. Maybe they will.
Bring it on.
You know, they got a real challenge there, though. If they show the NX before, they're going to just eat into their software sales on Zelda on the Wii U. Okay, I got to concentrate here. Okay, there we go. Woo, finally. Oh my god, and I have no extra characters. I'm dead. Oh my god. This is going to be a game that's going to make me swear a lot, I can tell. Okay. Okay.
A fire-wielding robot running wild at an oil refinery. I don't like the look of this at all.
Not exactly ideal conditions, I'll grant you that. Quickly now, back. Locate Mighty Number One.
That's more like it.
Okay, I can do this. There's definitely some skill involved in this game. You've got to pay attention, which I like. Okay. Starting to get this.
Here we go. Bring it on.
Okay. I think that was my checkpoint right there. No, no Fan Expo this year.
The world must burn!
We'll get back there again soon.
Pyro, wait!
Warning, multiple incoming robots detected.
But we are headed to San Diego Comic-Con. I don't know if anybody's going down to that.
It's confirmed. Pyro has gone rogue as well. Becky, you must hurry.
Whoa.
All right.
Bring it on. Bring it on.
Scott was doing some consulting for a VR company. Yes, Jay Lamp. He's been doing some freelance writing and stuff like that too. Keep him busy. All right, here we go. Good point, but I think I'd rather get the sales numbers from the new console plus Zelda with it. When did Twilight play? Right now. It is very. It's amazing that we're. Fuck, man, that's so ridiculous. Get up there! Oh, boy. Okay. I hate that thing.
Let's bring it on.
So I'm kind of living a nightmare here, live streaming a Mega Man game. Whew. This is, I feel very judged and inadequate, and These things are intense, and now I'm remembering. I'm sure I've had nightmares like this. Gonna be in front of a crowd of people playing a Mega Man type game and just doing stupid things like that, running into the wall. Don't run into the wall! They will bundle Zelda with the NX. Who knows, man? Maybe the NX is just going to be like an accompaniment to the Wii U. This is going to be very interesting to see what the hell they're thinking. I really have no idea. I had this crazy thought that what if the NX was just a controller for mobile games, and they were going to start publishing, or the mobile platforms, and they were going to start publishing all their consoles. All their titles on the mobile platforms, and so it wasn't just a store. Okay, I gotta pay attention. But it was actually like a world-class Nintendo controller. Wow. Oh, geez, that looks. That would probably make them so much money, and it's so logical, and so much straightforward business sense. But that's not how Nintendo ever operates. So I don't think they're gonna do that. It's one of the reasons why we all love Nintendo. Okay, wow. Okay, so I'm gonna jump down here. Oh, okay. Alright, okay. I am feeling some feelings of the tenseness while I play this, which I think is the, oh shit, appropriate way to play the game. I'm gonna swear like a trucker when I play this game. Yo, have you seen the two patents for the new PS controller design, Vic? No, I have not seen those patent controller things. No, I have not. I unboxed a Vive, and I played a little bit of this today so far. Wow. Okay. Now what? I'm screwed. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Huh. Can't believe that. I didn't mind this level design. I mean, it's kind of empty, but okay, I gotta fight the boss. But that level was kind of cool. I got it. It was intense. It was certainly not as imaginative as the best Mega Man levels, but it wasn't too bad.
Burn.
Uh-oh.
Burn.
If you send me, I'm Batwing on PSN. So if
you
send me your friend request, I will add you. Bonjour, Akamaru. Oh jeez. Oh. So cool. Yeah, that's right. Fine play, everybody. Dead. That was cool. That was pretty cool. I'm glad that some of you are watching my fine plays. That's pretty good. You can tell your friends. I can still play games. Okay, here we go.
Pyro! Finally!
You! Why you not burn?
What do you guys think? Should Batman have a plaid cape?
Burn.
Maybe just in Canada's Batman?
Burn!
Burn!
Pyro crash!
You burn.
You will.
Yeah, apparently, even Batman's happier in the new Justice League. Got you. Where's my fun play? Ow. Oh no. Ow. Oh no. He just hugged me to death. How do you come out of that? That's crazy. Just put him in a plaid shirt. He's undercover in Canada.
Pyro. Finally.
Plaid man.
You.
I'm Plaid Man.
Why you not burn?
Why you not burn?
You not.
Why you not? Why you sound like Cookie Monster? Cookie!
Burn.
Cookie!
I will crash and you burn!
Cookie! Ow. Oh.
You hear it come.
Whoa. Ow. Dabba. Oh, come on. Rah! Man, this is not easy. He cannot jump very high. The game is out. Yes, it is out today. Lumberbat. Lumberbat. I like that.
Here we go. Pyro. Finally.
You. Why you not burn? Why you not burn?
Burn.
Uh-oh.
Burn. That was a fun day in the VO booth for that guy.
And you burn.
Oh, he's crazy. Ow. I mean, that's like, where am I supposed to go? There's just fire in every direction. Not fair. Not fair. Ow. Fine play, yeah. Oh, jeez. Okay. Fight, dude. Fuck, I gotta burn. I don't even like. Oh, I'm against the fire over there. This is a hard level, man. I can't do it, man. I don't know what to do, man. I wish I had a more power, man. All right, let's go.
Pyro, finally.
You. Why you not burn?
Why you not? I wish I could skip this now, but he's still funny.
Uh-oh.
Why you not burn? Oh my god.
I will crash and you burn.
Oh god, this is crazy. Ah! Bah. Jumping is useless. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, I see. course. Whoa. Oh man, that's... No meme. It's the dumb version of Red Hulk. Did you just buy it? You guys all want to see if you can kick the ass of Pyro Man better than I can. I guarantee you, you can.
Pyro.
I just realized that I've been trying to jump over you. Him, and then I'm landing right in his fire because I forgot I've got the dash move, so I will now try to incorporate... Burn! Oh boy. Uh-oh.
Burn!
I wonder how many times we're going to watch this together.
Pyro crash! And
you burn! Oh, jeez. Nice.
Here it comes.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh no. Oh my god.
Here it comes.
Whoa. Oh. Rack. That's share play. It's the dumb version of Ref Fack, Mighty Number 9. Frack. Okay, I'm going to try this one more time, and then I am going to bounce out to the main menu to try a different level, because I don't want you to hate me. That's what I don't want you to hate me, because I can't get past this level. You know what I'm saying? So let's do it. I do kind of look like I'm doing sign language in the corner here, don't I? Okay, here we go. Ow. My two-year-old son is watching with me right now, quite some time before bed. Oh, quiet time before bed. I want to hear that voiceover outtakes for this character. Oh yeah, the voiceover outtakes. Burn! Okay, I have to quit out of here, because this is, what happens, though? Do I bounce back to the main menu? Let's find out. Let's do it. Yes. Stage select. Thank you. Let's see what else is out there. So we got to Pyro Man. You know what? Let's get some waterworks happening. Waterworks will help with Pyro Man, right? Let's give it a shot. Okami Itu, I don't know if this is a 5 out of 10 yet. Just getting started.
The main entrance is frozen shut.
I like that pyro level. That was okay. That was pretty fun. I just know I'm not powerful enough to take him out yet, so... The thing that's tough is, you know, even though those Mega Man games are dated... Do I go down? They were all so clever. And so, the graphics don't look great, but what we remember of those old Mega Man games was the level design and the challenge and leveling up, and that was all brilliant stuff. So that's what they had to contend with, not just creating a better looking 2D platforming thing like Mega Man, but they also had to create level designs and powers and all kinds of stuff that was better than what we remembered it, because in our minds those old classic Mega Man games look just as good as this.
Careful, Beck. Contact with any of that malfunctioning purification equipment could be fatal.
I haven't played that 20XX game that's out there, but I'm curious now. We are so spoiled with these 2D platformers, man. I used to spend $50 a cartridge on games like this, and if I had known what was coming, well, I kind of knew, but I would have been over the moon back then for games that looked like this. Whoosh! Don't touch the walls. Oh, yeah. Whoa, that's great. That was cool. You feel everybody's hating on this game too much. Yeah, that's why, Ukami. I wanted to check this out for myself, and why my review will be my own damn opinion. I do feel a little burned because I'm a backer and I had to wait a long ass time for this game. But hopefully, I forget all about that and just have a great time. That's pretty cool. Okay, what do I get in here? Secret, 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 goody, goody, goody. Secret, secret, goody, goody, secret. Yeah, secret goody. Nice. Okay, that's pretty cool. Nice and glowy. I like all of that. It's weird that this glow effect just happened, though. I don't remember the glow effect in the last level.
The entire place is like one giant ice rink.
Okay. I guess I should read what those icons mean above my head.
That's more like it.
Well, well, I get to see you.
Do I go out and buy it tonight or wait for the price reduction? There sure are a lot of awesome games out there. If you're not playing Doom or Overwatch, you are missing out. Or Uncharted 4 if you have a PS4. Or Dark Souls 3. Or Far Cry Primal. Or The Division. That's just off the top of my head. There's a lot of good games out. Star Wars Battlefront's got all that DLC out now. Uh-oh. I got into a soccer match between a couple robots. Hate when that happens. Oh no. Oh boy, I wish I could duck. Okay. No! Doom is really good, but I haven't played it. Ratchet. Oh, Ratchet and Clank as well. Game looks better than the bad reviews it's getting. Yeah, so far I'm pretty impressed with the visuals for sure. I wish I could hover. Gotcha. Come on! Got you. Okay. Now what? I am slipping on this ice, in case anybody's curious about that. It is a little laggy and choppy. I'm sure that'll be patched up. Oh. Right, can't jump on there? Come on, really? Frack, come on. Bologna. Bullshit. That sucks. I hate when they have level design that just doesn't explain itself like that.
That's more like it.
Oh no. Boss, there it is. There she is. Nice. Okay.
That's more like it.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, no. Oh. No. Gold Suit was a pre-order bonus. EPN should have a segment at the end of every where you recap the week's news and reviews, similar to what you had at the end of every ROTR. Yeah, that was pretty damn cool. That's a good idea, Jaylan. Oh. I love that when you fall on spikes and that's all right, there we go.
Bring it on.
No, no, no. Ouch.
That's more like it. That's more like it.
Oh, oh, oh my God. Oh, cheap ass! Oh, right. Of course it is. All right, let's see what a different stage looks like. Just give you a little tease of a bunch of stages. I'll do one more stage, and I think that's a pretty good taste. I don't want to reveal the whole damn thing. Not that I can beat any one of these bosses, by the way. Military base. I have no idea what way to start at all, so why don't we try the military base? Let's give this a shot.
You are all set, then?
Hey, Dunkmeister. Robo, whatever it's called. Ooh, Nintendo memories. That's a good idea. J-Lan. Just rocking it with the great ideas, brother. I am sure. Let's go. All right, let's see what happens here.
A military base they shut down years ago. It should be all but empty inside.
Jack, I'm reading multiple robot signatures ahead. Proceed with caution.
Here we go.
So in the future, I wonder if robots will play video games, and if Mega Man games and Mighty No. 9 will be some of their favorite games. Deep thoughts. By B. Lucas. Nice. Ouch.
Here we go. Here we go.
Too fancy right there. EPN should have a segment at the end of every week. Oh, that was Jay Land. How are things with you? Things are great. How are things with you? I ran them by Blake. I don't know if he told you then. We've been busy. So we haven't really had like a full-on production meeting about what else can we add to the post-production. See, the challenge is if I start cutting too much stuff, and I have been cutting some stuff, not as much as Blake has, or Bear, because Bear's working with us right now. Then I'm not playing games or seeing movies or, you know, like actually consuming the content that I'm supposed to be reviewing or talking about or streaming. So it's kind of a catch-22. We could just focus all our efforts on cutting, and we could do a lot because we have a lot of content that we keep shooting, but also lots of content that we have shot that could be recut and repurposed into lots of cool things. But we want to talk about new stuff, and so in order to do that, I gotta play the games and I gotta keep up. I will say, so far I'm enjoying this game.
Here we go.
And I'm already envisioning a day when Beck is invited into the Smash Brothers roster, and he fights alongside Mega Man, and there will be peace and harmony on the world. So I haven't played hours of this yet, So I don't know how I'll feel after an hour or two, and I definitely want to unlock some of these power-ups, because that's what this game's all about. And I haven't gotten anywhere near that yet, and that's bugging me. Oh, I gotta power up. Or give myself some health here, as a matter of fact. Okay, recover.
Okay.
Keep sticking missiles at me. Okay. I hate those screw things. Those screw things can suck it! Alright. Boom, red. Red barrels. Love the red barrels! Yes! Yes, give me your shell. Oh. Don't hit the screws.
Here we go.
Whew.
That's more like it.
Oh, I hate you guys. Nice. Oh no! I'm turning all red. Is it the lighting or is it me? I'm fine. Oh, jeez. Nice.
Here we go. That's for life.
Oh, I hate you guys. All right. Watch. Oh, oh, no. No. Get out of there. I'm not even gonna shoot those things. Oh! There we go. I do like the visual rewards when you do cool things, the gratifiers, the embedded accomplishment thing. I like that. That's cool. It's kind of like old arcade games. Go, 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 go! I'm not very. I don't have much health. Oh. Oh, please heal me. Heal me. Oh, give me more health. Come back. Come back. I need you. Uh oh.
The doors. I'm trapped.
Is that fear in your voice, Private Deck? A robot soldier does not feel fear. A robot soldier does not feel pain. Now fight on like you got guns. Heck, we're working on unsealing those doors. Try to hold.
Oh no.
That's more like
it.
Wow. Alright, let's heal myself. There we go.
Alright.
Did I make it? Did I make it to the boss?
That's more like it.
Nope, not yet.
Here we go.
Okay. Those are the most useless robot soldiers ever. They have one big eye. Oh no! Oh my god! Oh, I was bouncing all over the place. Oh! Man, you feel the deaths in this game.
That's more like it. That's more like it. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun. I haven't played enough to make a judgment, but I'm having a good time. So there's certainly elements of fun, and you're seeing the challenge. Like, it's kicking my ass already. I'm also, I'm trying to converse as I'm playing through this, so I'm not at my gaming best. I'm not at my, my paying attention or concentrating best. Whoa.
Here we go.
Tell me what game you are most excited for coming out of E3, out of all the stuff you previewed. What are you psyched for? Go ahead and add that to the chats or comments. Goodbye.
Here we go.
Oh shit. Oh, come on! If you zip to that, you should... Oh, that sucks. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna do one more level so we can see a different stage as well. So far we've done the pyro stage, we've done the water ice stage, and we did the military base stage. So let's see what else we can do. I want to get one of these things! Let's see, power plant, radio tower, highway, capitol building. I think the Vermilion Destroyer was an extra piece of content that I got because I'm a backer. So let's do radio tower.
All set, then?
I'm sure. Let's go.
Beck has arrived at the tower. Mighty number 6 must be transmitting from the apex.
Sorry to make you climb it on foot, Beck, but it's all part of the plan.
Oh. What the frack? Let's go. I can't get this guy? That's a cool boss. Or a cool enemy. I guess I shouldn't play this one with my daughter because swearing. Daddy's gonna teach you some new words today, baby.
As you can see already, the robot rampage is not letting up. It's chaos out here. Chaos!
Will this be the end of our proud republic, or will a hero in the revolution save the day?
Whatever happens, Holly News will be there. Your number one source for ethical journalism. We report.
The voice actors had fun, man. I like it. Get up there. All right. I like this stage, too. This stage is all right. It's a little, plain looking. But it's fun. Ooh. Nice. There we go. Oh. Look at me getting power-ups and such. Yes! Lucking out a little bit. Alright, hula heli. Nice. One thing I dig about this is that there aren't a lot of games with this kind of cutesy style right now. Like new games. Yeah, I'm really not doing well with the jumping. Oh, I would sure love a power-up. So basically, watch this video again for all the ways that you should not play Mighty No. 9. Okay, that was my gift to you. All of the ways where, if you play like me, you will not get very far. What the frack? Okay. I would love a heat-seeking missile too! Oh, I'm so doomed. We're doomed! Okay. Go away. Go away, helicopter. Thank you.
And now, Avi News Traffic from the Avi 1 Eye in the Sky Traffic Counter. Avi! We have an accident about to happen on the airship, Avi. A piece of trash causing trouble.
Yeah, it's not fully realized. It feels kind of sketched in, some of this stuff. You know, it could be... Okay. It could be just smoother and a little more refined. It looks like as many delays as this thing had, it still needs more time. Boo! I just shot a garbage can. Alright, let's go. Up, up, up. Just shot a garbage can that was shooting at me. Anything goes. Ooh. Something's down here. Something down here. What's down here? What's down here? Something? Something awesome? I'm not going over there. Screw it. Avoid the spikes that will kill you with one drop. Oh.
That's more like it.
Oh no. I will tell you this is making me want to play both Shovel Knight and Ori in the Blind Forest.
Ugh. That's more like it.
Oh boy. The wind ain't helping. Oh man. Oh yes. Wow.
This just had bad guys spotted on the west side of the radio tower. Bots are in pursuit. Not a problem with the weather. Thanks, Abby. We've got strong winds out there today. Be careful.
Ah.
That's more like it.
This is intense. No, 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 no. Oh. Sorry for all the swears and screaming. Okay, here we go.
This just had bad guys spotted on the west side of the radio tower. Bots are in pursuit. Not a problem with the weather. Thanks, Abby. We've got strong winds out there today. Be careful.
We do have strong winds out here today, and they're a pain in the ass. Oh my gosh. Oh. My hands are sweating. This is a good deal. This is working. I don't want my little character to fall. Come on, Beck. No. Oh man, that is a pain in the ass. Okay. No, I'm gonna die again. Oh no. God damn it. Oh.
This just had bad guys spotted on the west side of the radio tower. Bots are in pursuit. Not a problem with the weather. Thanks, Abby. We've got strong winds out there today. Be careful.
Get up there. Get up there. Do it. Do it now. Oh, you suck, garbage can. Shit. It's hard not to keep tapping that button when your finger's hovering right over it. That's hard. I'm hearing myself on the stream. I'm a potty mouth playing this cutesy cartoon game. All right. Get off of there. That's my ride. Okay. All right. Whew. Sweating. Okay. I have 550 points. Just a lot of pressure to get 550 points. Hardly seems worth it, Beck. All right. Don't know where I'm going.
That's more like it.
Thank you.
That's more like it.
Oh.
That's more like it.
Okay. Oh! Shippeda. There are sure a lot of deaths. I apologize to everybody. I'm certainly no pro at Mighty Number 9. Oh, I'm going back this way. Oh, no. I'm way back here. Oh, no. Thank you. I need that. This wind. Oh, fracking bullshit. Yeah, it is. I mean, I'm totally tensed up here. Yes. Paula Dinwin. Or Paladin One. Okay. That was the robots taking pity in me right there. I caught that. Mighty Number 9. Oh my god. Ah. I apologize, everybody. Clearly, I am not in a zen state to be able to deal with this right now. Okay, give me some of these. Give me. Thank you. Okay. Oh. Oh my God, guys. I'm sorry. I'm calling it. This is so hard. Let me answer a couple quick questions here while I got you here. Okay, and it was very intense. I was having a good time, actually, but you definitely need to concentrate with this game. This level reminds me of Eagle in Mega Man X. Nice, we've got some diehards in here. I'm sure that there's going to be a lot of great little secret Easter eggs and things like that for Mega Man fans. I should stream Journey for PS4. Yes, that would be fine. That would be super fun. I would like to do that. Zombie games, do you think Ukulele will be better? I think that's going to be a lot of fun too, hopefully. I mean, I am a little, and I'm sure all of you are right now too, a little wary of all of the crowdfunded games. There's so much drama behind the scenes. There's so many other things that these companies have to take care of when they do that, because they've got all of these expectations and they have to be completely transparent with the whole development process, and that just throws on a whole other layer of pressure on these dev teams. I hope what's happening in this crowdfunding kind of space that we're in is that the publishers are recognizing that there's a passion for these products and that they're stepping in to help them with managing some of these processes, like Deep Silver did here with Mighty Number 9. But I think it took a long time before that happened, and I think the Mighty Number 9 team had a lot of they ran into a lot of brick walls as they were trying to figure stuff out, because suddenly your business is not just delivering a game, but you also have to communicate with your people, the funders, the financiers, which is the crowd, on a regular basis. And as we all know, that's a vociferous and oftentimes very cynical and jaded and angry lot, you know. And sometimes they've had reason to be. There's been a lot of flamed out Kickstarter opportunities out there that have really pissed a lot of people off. But we'll see. Ukulele, I hope, turns out really, really, really well. I'm a big fan of the Rare guys, so I want them all to succeed in whatever endeavors they've got going on. Robo Sharknados, excellent stuff at E3. Thank you so much, Warconius. Thank you for watching. You rock. 50 Shades of Platforming Anxiety, at least 50 Shades. I was really, really tensed up there. Game of Thrones was ridiculous. Absolutely right, Crockett58. Mighty hard. Hard, but harder still when you've got an audience and you don't want to waste people's time and you're not really able to just sit and concentrate the way that these games demand. And that's the way I will play it for the review. I don't think I'm going to stream this again. I think you guys got a pretty good idea, but I'm going to definitely play this some more before I review it. Is that an IKEA chair? No, this chair was a gift from my wife. It was very expensive. She and recognizes how much butt sitting time I got to do to play these games, so she wanted to get me something that was comfortable and ergonomic and kind of felt like a captain's chair. It's got a cool style to it, and I love it. I feel very privileged in this chair. She took care of me in a big way. I have a wonderful wife. Anyone remember that Ant Simulator Kickstarter and then the devs blew all the money on alcohol and hookers? Yeah, it's stories like that that definitely put the fear into people on Kickstarter. Will I be checking out Umbrella Corps? Yes, I will. Just got the review code for that actually just today, so I'll be checking that out for sure. Psychonauts is really fun. Spidey82 mentioning that. Always go for the Metal Man before anyone. There's some advice from J-Lan. He asks, J-Lan also asks, which would I recommend, Ratchet and Clank or Doom? I love them both. I love them both. That is a good question. They're obviously very different games in tone, but there's some similar pleasantries with the loot that you get and the weapons that you get and the level design that you get. They're both so polished and refined, and they're great. You know what? They're the other. That's such a funny thing. Those two would almost work as a versus, because they're redos of classic games that have been done with so much love that you're bowled over by the end experience. I gave them both a 9. They're both incredible games. Man, you're making me pick between two of my favorite kids right there. I think I'm edging towards Doom. I wasn't expecting to love Doom as much as I did, and they killed it. And now they've got Quake coming. Hopefully that's as good as that. All right. Dash over the pillars. Okay, people are telling me how to play the game. Thank you. Yes, and listen, if you're watching this on a YouTube post later on, feel free to make fun of me and also send me advice. Let me know what you think of this game. If you bought it, tell me some secrets, because I'm going to be reviewing it and I'll be reading all of your comments. But for now, thank you very much. Thank you for watching, everybody. Have a great day, and I hope the sun is shining. It's summertime wherever you are. Peace.